Now, many Filipinos are financially unwell. Of course, reeling from lost incomes during the pandemic, rising commodity prices, and a weaker purchasing power. And as we revert to normal, now's also a good time perhaps to check on one's financial wellness and even take stock of the opportunities to still reach financial goals despite the economic headwinds. BPI Foundation Executive Director Owen Camayo joins us today to talk about BPI's Financial Wellness Fair. Hi, Owen. Glad you could join us.
Hi, Stanley. It's been a long while. Glad to be back.
Glad to have you here. Now, BPI's Financial Wellness Fair, tell us about it, what it is, and perhaps the dates to watch out for.
Well, essentially, you know, you did a great intro, but, you know, the BPI Financial Wellness Fair is really a platform, no, to showcase the, you know, the journey of some of our beneficiaries from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So we picked 25 selected beneficiaries, and it also provides them an opportunity to have extra revenue streams and market access, so they can network there and they can actually gain more customers with that exposure. And it's also part of BPI Foundation's 45th anniversary celebration. So this special event is also reflective of the overall BPI group's commitment, no, in creating a financial wellness culture for underserved segments and communities.
Okay, you're talking about underserved segments now. Who exactly are participating and what are they expected to learn from these engagements?
These are individuals, unemployed individuals who gained knowledge from some of our social development programs, specifically TechVoc. There's also some social enterprises. Okay. This segment is really a focus area for us at the BPI group. There's also nano and micro and small enterprises, which since last year or 2 years back, we started developing programs for them. It's just we realized that they are the backbone and they're the engine of our economy. So 25 beneficiaries will be showcased. Their products and services will be there on Glorieta over at the Palm Drive Activity Center on July 20 to 23.
Okay, so this is really an opportunity to look at livelihood and what it can do to a lot of Filipinos looking for one. Now, you've mentioned there are about a dozen or two success stories. Could you give us an example of these stories?
25 to be exact, Stanley. No, I think I don't want to, you know, preempt our your viewers. No, I'll just invite them to go to Glorieta from July 20 to 23. 25 select beneficiaries coming from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao will showcase their products and services, and you know. They can ask our viewers can ask our exhibitors or beneficiaries themselves on their transformation stories, so they can be inspired and, you know, and at the same time help them grow and you know, create their financially well life for them.
Yes, Owen, this is not the first time BPI has done this one.
And I think this is the first time we're actually staging a financial wellness fair. 45 years of the foundation's existence, it's the first time we're holding this. But, you know, in previous years, there were some sort of iterations, but not from the BPI Foundation.
Okay. Now, what sort of pain points did you wish to address coming up with a program like this one?
Well, essentially, like what you said earlier in your intro, it's you know, we're still a third world country, and it's a lot of poverty, a lot of poor people, underserved sectors and communities. Like, you know, with the COVID-19, it didn't really help, right? It even sank us deeper in the hole. So this is, I think, an opportune time, no, to really highlight the opportunities that can be achieved when you promote financial wellness, right? When we say financial wellness, we say you are financially literate. When you say financial wellness, we say that you are able to earn your own money. Okay. When you say financial wellness, we say that you have access to the basic or at least relevant financial services. So those are the three components or thrust that we look into in achieving a financial wellness culture.
Okay. Oh, and do you have a gauge as to financial wellness awareness in the Philippines? How pervasive is it, perhaps? And did the pandemic help push more people to question other opportunities that they need to explore to improve their lives?
Well, essentially, our barometer or our guiding light really is BSP, the Banco Central Pilipinas. No, what they report on, we actually follow. And you know, the reports indicate that though digital adoption for the financial sector has increased, still a vast majority of Filipinos are still classified as unbanked or underserved. So again, you know, we are just one of many organizations trying to make a change, and you know, we believe that there's no harm in trying. We cannot serve everyone, right? So we prioritize those communities, those underserved communities where BPI operate in. And you know, it's a long way to go. It's like the theme of our financial wellness fair, di ba? Kasama lahat sa pag-unlad. And it goes beyond the BPI group. So we're encouraging everyone to really join this movement of trying to build a financially inclusive nation.
Okay, the BSP is in fact having that advocacy as well, financial inclusion. A lot of banks are involved in recent moves to really improve financial inclusion. You were talking about the unbanked, still large number out there in the Philippines, particularly in remote areas where these services are perhaps not available. What changes are you seeing since the campaign became more aggressive, Owen?
It's baby steps, no, Stanley. It's how you really become consistent in what you're trying to drive, right? So again, I wanted to reiterate from our group, we wanted to really push for financial education. We wanted to give them capacity, skills to be able to learn how to earn and manage their own funds, and we wanted to provide easy access for relevant financial solutions. Those three aspects, those are the things, the programs that we develop and that we run revolves around those three priority areas. And you know, last year we've generated siguro around a million beneficiaries. Mm-hmm. I would say a million beneficiaries benefited from these interventions. And you know, we look to build on that number as we go on and we move on and we become more financially inclusive.
Owen, you know, sometimes you'd like to examine what is it that we have in the Philippines that can be used as perhaps or explored as an opportunity to push financial inclusion further. What do we have going for us?
I guess the pandemic was really a game changer for everyone. I think we now realize, we go to market and realize that we can't do it alone. We have to really learn how to collaborate, learn how to really look at the bigger picture, right? And with that mindset, with a change in mindset and hopefully behavior, you know, we're able to really work together towards a common goal of creating a better Philippines, right? Imagine if each and every one of the, how many thousands of corporations and businesses in the Philippines have the same mindset to be able to share prosperity for all, right? Become responsible, have an inclusive mindset. Then we'll have a better Philippines, Stanley.
Okay, so you're having this financial wellness fair, something that you're doing with other Philippine companies. Who else are you partnering with for this one?
Oh, well, to clarify, the financial wellness fair really is about showcasing some of our beneficiaries, honoring the partners that helped us transform the lives of these beneficiaries, and you know, and encouraging everyone, the general public, to see that there's really good in collaborating and creating a more financially well society. Because these are proof points already, Stanley. Mm-hmm. Imagine from an unemployed, here comes, you know, beneficiary A has his own product and is actually selling in a prime location like Glorieta. Imagine the impact. If people will know that and realize and be inspired, I think that would mean a lot.
All right, we're looking forward really to a lot of good stories from that encounter. Again, Owen, reiterate to us, tell us more about where the Financial Wellness Fair will be held. How can people get more information about your event?
Okay, BPI Financial Wellness Fair happening on July 20 to 23. It's happening at the Palm Drive Activity Center at Glorieta Mall in Makati City. You can get more details from our Facebook and Instagram accounts at BPI Foundation. Just type in BPI Foundation and even BPI main social media accounts. So encourage everyone to go there, visit, patronize the different products and services from our brothers and sisters from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. We cannot house all our beneficiaries, but at least 25 of these beneficiaries who have transformed their lives from being nothing to somebody, or at least they're on their way to being they're on their way towards financial inclusion and financial wellness. Be inspired. I encourage really everyone, every one of your viewers. So thank you so much, Stanley, for
and
this
thanks for sharing that inspiration as well, Mr. Owen Kawai, Executive Director of BPI Foundation. Thank you so much for your time and for joining us this afternoon.